You'll be pleased to see we've accomplished quite a lot.
Oh, you're not an authority on child abuse cases. That girl's sick. What she needs is a good psychiatrist.
What she needs is support and understanding.
Oh, next you'll be saying she wasn't to blame. It was all the children's fault.
Look, it's a combination of a lot of things. But making her feel guilty only adds to the problems.
Well, I don't know why people bother having children if they can't look after them.
You only ever see everything in black and white, don't you, Vera? And perhaps you're not to blame either. Parents have a lot to answer for in some cases.
What do you mean?
Oh, I'm sorry. Forget I ever mentioned it.
There was nothing wrong with my childhood. My mother was strict, but what's wrong with that? If I hadn't respected her, I wouldn't have looked after her all those years.
I'm talking about when you were a child. She was strict, all right. Wouldn't let you have any pets, wouldn't let you study painting, which you loved. But it goes deeper than that, Vera. She never said a nice word to you. It was always how plain you were, clumsy, how badly you were doing at school. Well, that's what you told me. She even made you feel guilty about your father walking out on you. Now, that's what I call mental abuse of a child, which can be just as damaging as physical abuse. I'm sorry, but I would have thought you, of all people, would have a little more understanding about what Gail's going through.
Well, that's the last time I tell you anything. And come to think of it, if your childhood was so wonderful, why don't you ever talk about it?
Thing must be real worried to you, Mrs. Davidson.
Oh, she'll be found.
Yeah, they never get away. I don't know why they want to get out in the first place. Funny she never mentioned anything about running off, though. I mean, you'd thought she'd have said something. We were mates. Closed book, that one.
Oh, do hurry up.
Oh, just finished, Mrs. Davidson.
These came for you.
Oh, just put them on the desk, would you, Miss Bennet?
Have you decided who's taking Burns's place?
Yes, I'll speak to some of the women before I leave. Could you wait outside until I've finished in here?
Well, that was a quick visit.
Yeah.
I returned to see how you went. Was Paul pleased to see you?
Yeah, he was at first. Then I told him about the money. He'd have thought I'd asked him for an arm or a leg or something.
Well, as I said, it's a risky business.
Well, yeah, I know, but I'm sure we can make a go of it. At least he could have done was give us a chance.
Well, maybe he will. Just give him time to think about it.
I doubt it.
Just give him time. And come on, I'm finished for the day. I'll see you out.
I've got it. I've never had to read so fast in my life.
Well, who is it?
Fellas.
Oh, fan bloody tastic.
Don't get getting excited. You're not going, remember?
Oh, yeah. What do I have to do?
Maybe you can do two good deeds at once.
Your attention, please. Most of you want the work release program to be a success. However, there is always the occasional person who abuses the privilege. There has been one such instance already. I trust it will be the last. Should there be any more trouble at the factory, I will not hesitate to cancel the scheme.
Why don't you stay in your cell?
You keep coming in here. I'm sick of the sight.
You leave at once.
Let go of her, Smith.
Now you know what it feels like.
I was going to allow you to work at the factory tomorrow, Hunt, but you certainly lost any chance of that. Are you hurt?
On your feet. You'll be safer in your cell.
I think 24 hours locked in their cells wouldn't do these two any harm, Miss Bennet.
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
This isn't going to make any difference to the others, is it, Mrs. Davidson? I mean, there are some women here who can be trusted. We all want this program to work, you know.
Yeah, if I'd known I was going to be...
You had your chance, Hunt.
For once, Smith, you've proven that you can be responsible if you want to be. Perhaps you would like the opportunity of showing us you can be trusted.
Mrs. Davis.
I want Smith to set an example to the women. She's to be allowed on work release tomorrow.
You can count on me, Mrs. Davidson.
Got a light?
What's the matter with you? Haven't you ever seen anyone light a match before?
I was hoping you might go up with her.
Bee's coming with us tomorrow.
Yeah? Good for her.
Not so good for you, though.
How come?
Oh, you don't reckon she's going to let you run a book out there, do you?
What's your stake in this?
Nothing. I was just looking after your interests.
Pull the other one.
Okay. I was planning on going into business with that bookkeeping Sheila.
Okay, what? What would she want with you?
You'd be surprised. But I don't want Bee fouling it up. So I thought you and me might get together and make sure she doesn't go. You know, join forces for the good of business.
Rack off, hairy legs.
Yeah, well, I know all I need to know about Talbot. Who else is there?
Well, there's Kay White. She sort of sees we've got everything we need, you know. She's real nice at first, even taking bets from Margot.
But
there's a real mean streak in her, Bee. She tried welching on a bet once, and the other day, a roll of material went missing, and Nolene had a go at her about pinching it, you know, just stirring. Well, she went right off the handle at Nolene, and I thought she was going to kill her there for a minute.
What a pity she didn't.
Where'd you get that off, then? Out of the storeroom. Want to play?
5-1, I can whop you.
You're on. Anyway, no need to worry about this Kay character, unless she gets in our way. And we're not going to give her that chance.
Hey, Margot. I believe you're still running a little racket at the factory.
Just keeping in practice?
Yeah, well, from now on, you can keep your practice on the inside. I'm just closing down your little bookie trade on the outside.
You can't do that.
I just did.
Hey, what about the game?
Stick it.
We'll play you.
Okay.
Thanks.
Right, you first, then it's my go.
You've already had a go.
I was just practicing.
Okay.
Well, that's not fair.
How are we going to do it?
Oh, will you come
on? For starters,
we've
got to beat Smith at her own game. Yeah. Show the screws she can't be trusted.
What are you going to do about Vince, Bee? They'll all get chucked out if you get caught.
They're always having accidents in factories. He's just going to have more than most. That's all.
I think Mrs. Davidson's making a mistake.
What do you mean?
Well, she's so busy trying to impress Andrew Reynolds that she's making errors in judgment.
Bee Smith.
Right. Mm. He sends Mrs. Davidson flowers and suddenly she loses her perspective.
Well, I doubt if that's the case,
Well,
Vera.
There's no other reason that...
Oh, there's no rush for those reports now, thank you.
Mrs. Davidson, both Mr. Fletcher and I think you're making a mistake letting Smith out tomorrow.
Well, I know that she's been behaving herself lately, but I thought that we'd agreed that she'd be the last one to go.
Well, I think it would do her far more good to be placed in a position of trust immediately.
She was an escapee. And after the Bryant incident, she's bound to get new ideas.
Well, security's very tight at the factory, Miss Bennett. They watch more closely there than here.
Well, that's another thing we want to talk to you about. The officers are getting tired of sitting around twiddling their thumbs at the factory.
But I thought you were worried about the possibility of escape. I'm sure you'd be the first to agree that... two officers are needed on duty at all times. Good night.
Excuse me. I'm looking for someone. They call him the Weasel. They said he might live around here.
Who's they?
Oh, you know, they only gave me his name and all. They said to ask around.
What do you want him for?
I got a little job for him.
Tell me who they are. I might be able to help.
Doreen Anderson.
Never heard of her.
Well, maybe the Weasel has, huh? Look, it was a long time ago, you see. I think she went under another name then. Debbie something or other.
Debbie Ray?
Yeah, that's it. She said he was the best.
He is. All right, what do you want me to do?
How do I know you're the Weasel?
Do I look like a bantam rooster? On the table.
I want my passport made legal, and I want my name changed.
$500.
What?
$500 COD. It'll be ready tomorrow. No Sponduli. You'll be saying goodbye to this, too.
Don't worry. You'll get your money.